In this Groov workshop, I'll show you how to get started with your new Groov box. I've already unpacked the box, including this quick start guide, which we'll follow in this video. As step one mentions, I'll need a computer with a modern web browser, and also an Opto 22 pack running modern firmware, or an OPC-UA server, like KEP Server EX from KEPware, shown in other videos. In later steps, we'll need this activation key, and the serial number and default host name shown here. First, connect ETH0 to a network that has DHCP and DNS, like the one in this building. Then connect power. Now, I'll press this button firmly until we see green LEDs. Your link activity light should be blinking too. Next, we'll use a modern browser to activate and set up the box. I'm using Firefox. Navigate to activate.groov.com. I'll log in with my email address and my MyOpto22 password. Click Go. Enter the activation key and click Go. And my Groov is now activated. I'll click down here on Enter Serial Number, which is the first step in getting my license file. Here's where I type that 6-digit number from the bottom of the box, and one more time to verify, then click Submit. Now I can click here on Get License File to download that file somewhere I can find later. Since our Groov box has been activated and we've downloaded the license file, we're ready to connect. Using just a modern browser, we're going to apply that license file, create some accounts, and start building pages. I just need that default hostname found on the bottom of the box. Here in the address line of my browser, I'll type HTTPS, and the S is important here because we're making a secure connection to the Groov web server. After that HTTPS, type :// opto- and the rest of your particular default hostname. I'll get the security warning, which may look different in your browser. I'll accept the security warnings to continue on. Next, I'll see this Welcome to Groov page. If you're not getting here, your network setup may be different. Check the Groovbox User's Guide on our CD or our website. Also remember, product support is free. Now we're going to create two username password combinations. The first is for Groov Admin, used to administer the physical Groov box. From admin, you can do things like change network settings and apply updates. The second username and password will be one of many you'll have as part of your Groov project. These logins let you decide who has what access to the different pages you'll build in your project. Let's go ahead and create this initial Groov box admin account. Confirm any additional security warnings. I'll type my username password and confirm the password again. Don't forget this username and password. If you do, you'll have to reset the box back to factory defaults. Next, click Create Groov Admin Account. Okay, so we've created our Groov Admin Account. Now we're ready to start administering this box, starting with installing that license file we downloaded earlier. Without the license file, you can still use Groov in trial mode. I'll install that license file. And now we're ready to start building our project, starting with the first user account. I'll type the username, password, password again, then create Groov build account. Now I'm here in Groov build. This is your development environment. Down here, we'll add our pages, which will show up here. In this canvas area, there's the desktop and tablet tab with this handheld tab where we can arrange gadgets for the smaller handheld devices like a smartphone. Down here, we select gadgets to put on each page, either by choosing the gadget first or starting from the tag with this tab. Let's get some tags to display. These can come from an Opto 22 pack or just about anywhere via an OPC-UA server. We recommend KEPware's for accessing non-Opto 22 packs. I'm using their free KEP Server EX trial, downloaded through groov.com. I'll show you the OPC-UA option first. select Configure, Devices and Tags from either here or here. Click Add OPC-UA Server, give it a name, then the name or IP address of your server, colon and port number. Click Add Server. To connect directly from Groov to a pack, click Add Opto 22 Controller. Type the controller's address, then browse to that controller's idb.txt file. This text file is generated by pack control when you compile or download your strategy in the same folder as the strategy itself. I'll browse to a copy of that text file, then click Import and Close. Now I'll have lots of tags to choose from. But before I connect these tags to gadgets, I need a place to put them, so I'll create my first page. Click Add Page here on the left. I'll name this first one Home. Click OK. Now I'm ready to add a gadget. I can do this from the bottom right here in Groov Build, either starting by selecting a tag or from this Gadget tab. Then I can either double-click the gadget I want or click and hold to drag and drop it onto the page. Now, since I haven't yet selected a tag, I'll go up here in the top right to my gadget properties and choose from my pack strategy tags. I'll select my store temperature here, then adjust the min and max properties. For this round gauge, let's add an optional red line type zone for when it gets too hot. I'll make the start value 80 degrees and the end value 90 and change the color to red. Now let's check it out. I'll switch to Groov View by choosing File, Save All and switch to Groov View. It's just that easy. I'm looking at my store temperature. To switch back to Groov Build, I'll click on this gear here in the top right corner. Notice here at the top, I'm in the Desktop and Tablet tab. On this Handheld tab, a slightly different handheld version of this page is automatically built for me. Check this out. If I add another gadget on this desktop version of the page, then click on the Handheld tab, I have all the same gadgets, but I can now arrange them how I want for handheld devices. See how nicely that scales? That's why we say Groov is made for mobile. For more information on creating the rest of your project, look under the Help menu in Groov Build or visit groov.com. Thanks for watching.